Welcome back. In this video, I'll be going over creating a construction site logistics plan. This is a sample Revit project that I have here that shows some potential construction sites in different locations. This one in particular has like the footprint of the building and locations for cranes. This is another one that shows actually the word site on it. So this is the one we will be focusing on in this video. I'll start off by selecting the reveal hidden elements in Revit. It's a light bulb at the bottom. And this shows several items that are not currently visible, such as the masses that were created in order to set the location of the crane radius. So I'm going to unhide those masses, and then I'm going to right click, zoom in region, and kind of zoom in to see what these masses are about. So this is the location of the crane at the center of the circle, and then the radius of each of those cranes. Depending on which one you use. All right, so back to the target site. The target site, which is a green field right now, has next to it a parking for the trucks and some construction trailers. Okay, there's a single wide and a double wide trailer over there. So this video is meant for construction management students and professionals, not so much for architects. But you know, everyone can benefit from this. So we're checking out here the site yard layout, which is a floor plan layout of the site, so you can work in both 3D or in 2D. I have here a document that shows 8 requirements for what needs to go on a site logistics plan, such as location of field offices and trailers, temporary toilets, safety measures such as fences, location cranes, staging of materials and equipment, traffic flow for trucks, stormwater pollution measures, and so on and so forth. So what we're going to do is we're going to start by dragging and dropping the Port-a-John temporary toilet from the browser to the site. And this is located under the site folder. Okay, so you look under families, site folder, and you can drag and drop those from that browser, project browser, to the site itself. I'm going to select the top portion of that view cube in order to work in top down, and then I'm going to use the copy command, copy multiple, constrain, so that I'm copying in a straight line. Back to the home view of the view cube. And here we go. Now we have temporary toilets. So we just satisfied one of the requirements of this site logistics plan list. Next, we'll work on the construction field offices, or single wide or double wide trailers. Now you can drag and drop those from the browser, but you already have some on this side of the site. So I'm going to just simply copy that over to where I want to put them, okay? And then I'm going to hit the escape button, of course, between commands, and use the move command, uncheck the box for constrain, and move them to where I want them to be placed, okay? So without that constrain uncheck box, you can't move it in that direction. Then simply use the copy command or control drag to copy those double wide trailers. All right, next is the fence or the fences. So the green field is the target area for the construction site. We're going to simply put a fence around it, a simple rectangular fence. But we do have a fence that's sitting on this side here, so we can just simply go into borrow that by doing a right click, create similar. Right click on the fence, create similar, and go ahead and turn the view the top view of the cube in order to work a little bit more easier this way, so we can snap to the corners of this green field. Once we snap to the four corners of the green field, now we have a construction safety fence. All right, we're going to do a right click zoom to fit and right click zoom region, and then zoom in to see what that fence looks like. So this is the fence. I'll select the fence, right click, and select all instances in the view, and this will give me will confirm that we have a fence that's 6 feet high according to the properties on the right hand side. All right, let's put some doors in that fence. So I'm going to select the door command in the architecture menu, and then Revit will say there's no doors, we'd like to load a door. Yes, so we'll go to the Revit content library, select the doors folder, select just any door really. Double flush panel is good. Select a large door and go ahead and bring it in and simply place it where it is needed. So I'm going to place a door at every side of the rectangular site. Okay. The door itself is bigger than the fence. The fence is 6 feet, the door is 7 feet. So we need to make the fence a little bit higher. So I'm going to select the fence. Right-click, select all instances in the entire project or in the view, and change the unconnected height to 8 feet. That will just make it look better. This is a cosmetic thing. We don't need to put an 8-foot fence. You can put a 6-foot fence. All right. Next, we will need to add our cranes. But before that, let's go ahead and highlight those in yellow to make sure that we are done with them. Okay. So let's put the cranes. Cranes can be loaded from another, from the content library, or we can, if we have them here, we can go to the families folder, generic models, tower cranes, drag and drop on the site. I'll put the crane right there around near the middle of the green field, outside the fence. That should satisfy that requirement, but I can do better than that. I can bring another crane that is a little bit shorter for tactical movement of materials from the staging area. So where is that located? It's located under Oh, here you go. So before we do that, let's bring a concrete truck. That would help visualize how big the truck is and how much radius you need for the turn. And here's the construction crane. That's the small one that you can put there, 75 foot. You can put there also, makes it look more official. Okay, let's highlight this in yellow, move on. The remaining part of this equipment, you know, erosion measures and stuff like that, those can be taken care of with just simple annotations, text annotations, as opposed to model something in the model. So we're pretty much done with this. We just need to annotate that, change the scale, put it on a sheet, and then give it the proper name, and then, you know, save to PDF. So what I'm going to do is right click and make a duplicate copy of this 3D view in the browser and call it 3D site logistics, a plan, or something else, whatever, diagram, 3D site logistics diagram. Okay. And we close the other view. And since now we have a duplicate copy of it, we can turn on our crop region, right? At the bottom of the view, and go ahead and slide those, the crop region boundaries, over near the green field, because we only need to see a small portion of it. Otherwise, the scale has to be so small and the text will not read very well. So in order to see those cranes and trailers and temporary toilets and fans, we need to zoom in closer. Okay, so we have a new duplicate copy of that. I'm going to do a right click on the sheets folder, create new sheet, and I'll use this sheet type. And then what we're going to do is we're going to drag and drop our new view onto the sheet. Okay, obviously it doesn't fit because it's 1/8 inch scale. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the scale to 1 inch equal to 30 feet. That's maybe too small. What I'm going to do also is drag the end of the view title and then move the view title over to this away from the plan. I'll change the scale accordingly until I get what I'm looking for. I think 1 inch equal 20 feet is good. I can do a little bit better than that. I can probably go to 1 inch equal 10 feet. No, that's too big. Let's do 1 inch equal 16 feet. That should do it. 1 inch equals 16 feet. But if we have a little extra on the sides, what we can do is double click on the view itself in order to activate the view, and then slide, just make the crop region a little bit tighter than what it is right now. That should do the job, okay? Double click outside the sheet in order to deactivate the view, and then if we want to go back and annotate, we have to double click and activate the view again, move the site text where it should be, and the site text now seems to be a little bit too big, so I'm going to change that to from 1.5 inch aerial to 1 inch aerial. So I'll do that by duplicating, you know, edit type on the text on the properties, make a duplicate copy, change the size. And this is a 1 inch aerial annotation text. Now, for the other requirements, we can, as I said before, we're going to use annotation text, which is labeled A on the menu. So annotate menu A, and then use any of those with leaders, the curve leader, for example. And then point to something and then give it a name. For example, this is a fence, right? So I'm going to call this fence or construction safety fence. Again, the text is too big, so I'm making a duplicate copy of it. Change that to a different size, maybe like 1/2 inch. Half inch aerial, not 1/2 inch, so that we can recognize it later. Revit does use a TrueType font, just like Windows, so it's, please don't use those old fonts that come from AutoCAD. It's hideous, you know. Stay with the TrueType font. And Arial is the standard out-of-the-box font for Revit, so let's use that to avoid any headaches in the future. Okay, so we can update that text, move it to place, looks good, right click on it, create similar, and then repeat the process again for the temporary toilets, for the construction trailers, for the crane. And move them into place. Now, if you want to get fancy with this, you could use tags and keynotes to tag those elements, but you know, this is something that is not covered in this video. I may cover that in a future video, but for the purpose of this site logistics plan, this is good enough. So anything that is not modeled, such as erosion measures or truck routes, which are already there, the street, the road, you can just take care of that with a note. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another note here for the what is called the erosion control measures, huh? So this would be just a silt fence. Anything else you want to add to this, such as staging areas for materials and equipment, you could do that as well in the same way. Now, signage is important for wayfinding. So when trucks come to the site, you want to put a big sign there saying this is a truck route for deliveries, so people know since they've never been to the site before. Now, the last part of this is to actually update the title block. So right now, this is a sample model used by some design and construction people that we do want to update. So anything that we can update on the actual title block, we can do that. Let's go ahead and do that. Such as the project name and the view name. Okay, so essentially what I'm going to do is just remove the top thing by putting just a little dot there, and then I'm going to change the bottom one to construction project, and then the little one below that to site logistics plan. Okay, so obviously this is very generic, it would be you'd have to, if this was the real project, you would have to pick the real project. The sheet number also is important. Right now, I'm going to call it CM101. This could be, the course name, CM602, whatever. Now, the logo is important here because I want to make sure that everyone who's doing this as an assignment is able to double-click on the sheet to open, save as, to a file, save as. Remove the logo of the previous company and then add your own logo, right? So you could go to, if you don't have a logo, you can just simply, add the school logo, for example. Okay, so we Googled the logo of the school. And we simply open that up and do like a right click, open a new tab, and then save as picture. So you're going to use the insert menu, insert image, and bring that image from wherever it is. Right, once that image has been brought in, then you simply you're going to place it and size it to fit that box. But if you're doing this as an assignment, you must put your name on this. That's how I would know which who this is for, right? Make sure you put your name on it. Anything you want on this sheet, and then load that back into the project. Right, so this is a Revit family or a component that can be saved and use the load into project command to load it back into the project. Now, that's not enough. You have to go to the sheet view, CM101, and then go to the properties, use the pull-down menu, find your custom sheet, and replace the old sheet with a new sheet. Okay, so it's from the Revit property type selector. So now we have the logo, we have your name, we have the site logistics plan, and now we can save the project and print as PDF. Now, there's two ways you can print as PDF. You can use the print command, right? Print to Microsoft PDF, select views and sheets, uncheck the box for views, uncheck the box for the old sheet, and pick the new sheet, which is Site Logistics Plan, CM101. And then make any adjustments you need to print to PDF, including going to the setup and landscape format, not portrait, and selecting the sheet size. So the appearance should be set to a medium, but then if you're printing on a basically to a small sheet, you need to print zoom to fit. This is not the recommended workflow. It's the workflow that you would need if you didn't have the PDF, if you weren't working with Revit 2022. And you wanted to use the print to Microsoft PDF. Again, there are two ways you can print to PDF. This is the way to print if you're not working in Revit 2022. And the next method I'm going to show is the best method, which is using the export function to PDF. Thank you for watching.